And yes, and I'm going to discuss about coronavirus disease 2019 or COVID-19. Let's start from virus. A virus is a pathogenic microorganism that infects cells of living things. It can only replicate in the cells of living things because viruses do not have a cellular equipment to reproduce themselves. A virus is a transition of living things and inanimate objects. As living things, viruses have DNA or RNA. Viruses can multiply. But as inanimate objects, viruses can be crystallized. The next is virus structure. The virus head contains nucleic acid or DNA. The capsid is a protein sheath which covers the virus head. The tail of the virus is a plug sticking to the body of the organism it attacks. And the thing we should know too is virus life cycle. So there are two types of cycle. There are lytic and lysogenic cycles. Lytic cycle will be done if the host cell is weaker than the infection power. Lysogenic cycle will be done if the host cell is stronger than the infection power. Lytic capable virus is also called as virulent virus. Both capable virus, or lytic and lysogenic capable virus, is also called as separate virus. So here are the steps of those cycles. From the lytic cycle, there are adsorption, injection, then replication, forming, and lysis. And lysogenic cycle, the first step is adsorption, injection, merging, synthesis, division, forming, and the last is lysis. Okay, let's start with coronavirus. COVID-19 comes from the coronavirus group. Coronavirus is the common name for corona viridae. It is divided into SARS, MERS, and COVID-19. Those three coronavirus is a pandemic incident. Coronavirus causes respiratory infections, including the common cold. There are no vaccines or antiviral drugs yet to prevent or treat human coronavirus infections. So what is the difference between endemic, epidemic, and pandemic? Endemic is a disease that exists permanently in a particular region or population. Epidemic is an outbreak of disease that attacks many people at about the same time and may spread through one or several communities. Pandemic is when an epidemic spreads throughout the world. This graph shows the pandemic viruses from year 165 until now, 2020. This data was updated on last 11th March. What is the difference between those coronaviruses? Okay, let's start from SARS. It was identified in November 2002 in Guangdong province, China. It spread to 26 countries in North America, South America, Europe, and Asia. It took incubation about 1 to 14 days, transmitted from weasels to humans. And MERS was identified in 2012 in Saudi Arabia. It spread to 27 countries in Europe, Africa, Asia, and North America. It took incubation about 2 to 14 days, transmitted from camels to humans. And COVID-19 was identified on 7th November 2019 in Wuhan province, China. It took incubation about 1 to 14 days. COVID-19 is not as dangerous as SARS and MERS, but the spread is much faster than SARS and MERS. It is expected transmitted from bats and snakes. COVID-19 spreads from the sick person droplets when they cough or sneeze. These droplets which contain viruses then stick and spread everywhere around that person. COVID-19 enters our body through nose, mouth, or eyes. So I will explain the relation between coronavirus and the temperature. As we have known, COVID-19's contagion and spread is pretty fast. There are measurements of contagions called an R0 value or R0. The R0 of coronavirus is about 2 to 2.5. It means that each person spreads the disease to about 2.2% on average. Due to Business Insider's Singapore website, some researchers found that for every 1.8 degree increase in temperature and 1% increase in humidity, the coronavirus R0 value will decrease by 0.02 and 0.04. Probably, It's one of the reasons why COVID-19 spreads faster in Europe than in other countries. It's because Europe countries today is in transition between winter and spring season, so the temperature there is pretty low. According to CNBC News on 17 March 2020, the World Health Organization is considering airborne precautions for medical staff after a new study showed the coronavirus can survive in the air in some settings. So coronavirus is now confirmed to be airborne. It can survive in the air up to 8 hours or more depending on the conditions such as temperature and humidity. It can also survive in copper up to 2 hours, in paper up to 4 hours. According to hippie.com, coronavirus can survive in plastics up to 3 days, in cardboard for 24 hours, in stainless steel for 3 days, in glass for up to 4 days, in rubber for 8 hours, and in woods for up to 4 days. And here are some common symptoms you should know. They are coughing, cold, sore throat, fever, headache, loose lips or face, and trouble in breathing. So who is at higher risk being infected by coronavirus? They are elderly aged more than 70 years old, people who have a history of other diseases such as diabetes or heart disease, and people who have a history of pneumonia or respiratory illness. According to the doctor's finding in Hong Kong, some patients they just recovered little gaps when walking a bit faster. The Hong Kong hospital already made the findings after studying the first wave of patients who were fully recovered from COVID-19. Out of 12 people in a group, 2 or 3 people saw changes in their lung capacity. They said that some patients might have a drop of 20% to 30% in lung function. The statements affect to elders whose immunity was decreased. How is the solution and precaution of COVID-19? The first is keep your distance for around 2 meters from someone who is physically coughing or sneezing. Second is avoid crowds. We don't know who might be sick. Sick persons droplet can stick in these things: their hands, cup, stair railings, train straps, lift buttons, pants, phones, notebooks, and many other things. The third is wash your hands with soap and flowing oil often. Don't depend on hand sanitizer. So what is the difference between hand sanitizer and soap? So there are an experiment using bread. Here you can see the comparison between bread cleaned with soap and water and bread cleaned with hand sanitizer. And here is why soap is more effective than hand sanitizer. So when is the best time to use hand sanitizer? It's when you're far from hand wash facilities, when you're difficult to find clean water, and when you are traveling. After you're using hand sanitizer 5 times in a row, you must wash your hand with soap to prevent antiseptic resistance. The fourth step is wear a mask when going outside of your house. The fifth step is don't touch your face. The sixth is drink mineral water often. And remember, drinking water doesn't kill coronavirus, but it can manage our immunity. So we can manage our immunity by maintaining cleanliness, get adequate sleep and rest, get right amount of exercise, eat nutritious and balanced food, sunbathing, and consume vitamins if necessary. The seventh is social distancing. It is the best way to help stopping the spread of coronavirus. And the last is self-quarantine. And here are the COVID-19 cases mapped.